So, what's on the itinerary for today?
Dr. Albert Wensley squinted at a neatly printed schedule made by his secretary. You have a meeting with the assistant researchers today at 10, a quarterly review of the status of all objects under your supervision, a meeting with Dr. Loof at 3, and an appointment with Director Owings at 5, Dr. Wensley.
His secretary read off her itinerary.
Here's your coffee.
Thanks, Liz. I'm going to go and do some reviews then.
Dr. Wensley sipped at his steaming mug as he strolled out of his office and down to the cell containing the most infamous occupant of Site 118, its resident Keter, SCP-2006.
Well, might as well check on 2006 first. Shouldn't take too long, I think. The newbies can probably accompany me for the rest of the reviews,
Dr. Wensley mused to himself. After flashing his security card at the camera, standing for a retina scan, validating a fingerprint scanner, and staring at the memetic kill agent, Dr. Wensley patiently waited while the steel doors of SCP-2006's containment area whooshed open. Strolling into the room, he was greeted with salutations and acknowledgments from the various assistant researchers and other staff in the control room for SCP-2006. Waving a hand at the assorted rabble, he walked over to the surveillance array, where a young man sat idly tapping his pencil while staring at the monitors.
"Morning, Cam,"
Dr. Wensley said while placing a hand on the man's shoulder. The man jumped for a moment. He swiveled around and saw Dr. Wensley's friendly smile.
Morning, Dr. Wensley.
He startled me for a minute. How are you? Assistant Researcher Cameron Hayworth asked.
Good, good. How's 2006 doing this morning?
What form is he in? Wensley sipped at his mug while looking at the monitor.
It's one of those slug monster things. Oh, I remember. 1964. The Creeping Terror, the young researcher replied.
Good work. I think I'll take a look at it today.
Wensley set down his mug and walked over to the door of the hallway leading to SCP-2006's containment cell.
Watch the screens, Cam. Keter's a Keter.
Dr. Wensley stood in front of the containment door and went through another round of safeguards, even stricter than the last. The doors whooshed open again, and he began to walk down the hallway.
2006 is always interesting to deal with, and at the very least, it's good for a smile when you're out of the chamber,
Wensley thought to himself. As he came before the last door that separated the containment chamber with the rest of the facility, he faced a small black box mounted on the wall of the last doors. Dr. Wensley, in a firm and even tone, spoke into the box.
Dr. Albert Wensley, Level 3 Departmental Director and Senior Researcher. The rats were in the souffle again.
Full body scan and voice credentials accepted. Prepare for Keter Entity Chamber Breach,
a mechanical voice responded. The door slid open silently. The chamber seemed empty, but Wensley knew better. As he strolled in, and culled to his mind notes from his acting class, a slimy, hideous, dripping wet, and utterly ridiculous-looking slug monster rapidly slid into view.
Your time has come, pathetic ape child. The creeping terror has arrived, and the horror of a race beyond your comprehension is ready to lay waste to your people. Doom is here, and it is the face of I.
The slug monster roared, face tentacles flopping around.
Oh no, please spare me. I'm just a puny mortal who wished to talk to SCP-2006. Please, no!
Wensley cried out in mock fear as he fell to the ground, quivering. The slug monster roared in laughter and flopped its tentacles around.
Oh, Doc, it's me. I'm not really the creeping terror. Did you like that one, Doc? I thought it was pretty good.
Oh, SCP-2006. Boy, you really had me going for a bit. That was terrifying.
I agree, it was quite good. Really scary.
Thanks, Doc. I've been really working on it. You know, Doc, I was thinking about something.
Oh, what's that?
Boo!
Wensley jumped and made a show of stumbling. As he came back to his feet, SCP-2006 was laughing again.
But seriously, I was thinking about something for real.
Oh, okay. What were you thinking about?
How to scare people the best. I'm always looking for more material, you know?
Oh, you're already the best at scaring people, SCP-2006. I don't think that I've ever seen scarier.
Really?
The slug monster looked like an expected young child yearning for approval from an older sibling.
Really?
Thanks, Doc. You know, though, I think that really makes a statement about fear and its repercussions on the status of humanity, though, and what it truly means to be afraid.
Of course.
Wensley did a double take. He had never heard sophisticated language from SCP-2006 before.
What?
He asked, slightly shocked.
Fear. What does it mean? If an individual is afraid of something, what does that mean? Do they think that it can harm it? What of a phobia? Is there something inherently harmful there? No. Then what is fear? The previously friendly slug monster's voice had suddenly become slow and measured, with a deliberate pace. The bubbly, genial SCP-2006's previously excited tone now dripped with a slight mocking sound, and rolled over Dr. Wensley's ears in an uncomfortable manner.
Good one, SCP-2006. That's a really scary thought,
Wensley replied, still somewhat taken aback. Yes, is it not? Human mortals in their fear. But do you know what is truly terrifying, Doctor?
What?
The knowledge and realization of concepts that violate a sense of safety. Humans build their little thoughts and bubbles where they believe that they are safe. Even you and your foundation believe that you are safe because of your knowledge and your special containment procedures. Everything is based on safety and peace of mind. The slug monster was still as it stared off into the containment chamber. Its words were spoken with a gravity and tone that contradicted everything Wensley knew about the anomaly.
What are you saying?
What I'm stating is that your mindset is predicated on the belief that you have successfully contained these SCP objects. Now, consider this. You have many objects that are contained on the strength of your deception. What if this deception that your organization so prides itself on were not being upheld? What if the Foundation itself is the one being deceived? A cold pit of fear formed in Wensley's stomach. He gulped slightly as he contemplated the implications. He suddenly felt very, very alone, locked in the chamber with SCP-2006. The slug monster, originally seeming so harmless, slowly swiveled its head around to look at Wensley and smiled. "Are you scared, Doctor?" Wensley began to back away. "I see that you're going. Have a good day, Doctor." As Wensley opened the doors behind him, he never took his gaze off SCP-2006 and its smile. "Oh, and Doctor?" Boo! Wensley fell backwards in genuine fear as the doors opened. He quickly crawled out of the room and the doors slammed behind him. As he rose to his feet, he heard SCP-2006 begin to laugh.